The most common and universal file format for 3D printing is STL. It was released in 1987 and it's that simple. An STL file describes a raw, unstructured, triangulated surface. It doesn't contain any scale, color, or material information. I'm sure you've at least once encountered an STL model with tons of errors. There is no validation, it's just a bunch of triangles. So you can create holes, non-manifold edges, flipped normals, self-intersecting models. It's good enough most of the time. But isn't there a newer, better file format that we could use for 3D printing? Meet the FreeMF, a new open source file format designed specifically for additive manufacturing. It includes complete model information contained within single file. One or more meshes, scene scale, textures, colors and materials, manufacturing process data, such as all Prusa Slicer settings, designer's name, description, copyright and license terms, and for example thumbnail image. But there are tons of other advantages. The data are stored in a human-readable XML-based format. As a matter of fact, if you change the extension from FreeMF to ZIP, you can look at what's inside the FreeMF. And because it is an archive, just saving your model as FreeMF will reduce the file size about 2 to 3 times compared to STL. Furthermore, FreeMF provides a clear definition of manifoldness. It's impossible to create a FreeMF file with non-manifold edges. And there is no ambiguity for models with self-intersections. Single objects can be referenced or moved without changing the mesh. And multiple identical objects can be placed referencing the same mesh. So, where STL would make a copy of every triangle for every copy of a mesh, FreeMF will simply note that this object has a new instance and saves its location. Now, what you'll probably benefit the most from is support in Prusa Slicer. Let's say you prepare a model to print. You take your time and create custom supports. Set up the variable layer height. Or adjust the infill with modifiers. If you then select File, Save Project, a FreeMF file will be created with every setting included. Whenever we slice something, we always save the project file as FreeMF. You can save multi-material objects with the right colors already assigned. Or you can save SL1 files with your manually edited tree supports. When you're sharing your model, it's fantastic if you upload a FreeMF. If you want to, you can always upload STL as well, but it's really not necessary since you can easily export STL from the FreeMF file. When someone downloads your FreeMF, they will benefit from all the work that you put into the print preparation. But they can change anything they want. Typically, they'll choose a different filament profile. Of course, it's not a perfect format. Cura won't load Prusa Slicer settings, and vice versa, Prusa Slicer won't load Cura's settings. But FreeMF, being open source and supervised by the FreeMF consortium, there is space for a further development of the specification. So, what do you think? Are you using FreeMF already? And if not, will you give it a shot? Next time you're asking someone for STL, maybe try asking for a FreeMF instead. And as always, happy printing!